How are we doing, guys?
Josh played some last year as well in games where guys got hurt. He's at a good ball camp. He's a guy that is physical, very smart, conscientious. And he's a guy you can depend on in that situation to know what to do. Like all players, he's learning, you know, once you are thrown into a role where instead of getting 10 to 15 plays a game, you're getting 50. I think he navigated that well. In ball camp, we do a lot of putting guys that are in backup roles in with the ones, guys that are ones in with the twos, so you build some kind of camaraderie as a group, some kind of gel. And so those things paid off in that situation. He's worked with Lino, he's worked with Raheem, so they've had some work together throughout fall camp just in case something like this happened. So I thought he stepped in, did a good job. He's not a guy that went there and bust, and he felt like there was going to be this huge drop off in the communication around what we do defensively. So he did a good job in the playing around 50 plays.
Coach, Iowa didn't do anything especially fancy, but they seemed to just do everything well. Defensively, Indiana just looked a step behind, which was a little surprising with so many returning starters and a core group. Was there some communication with you having to come in and learn the system, or is there still some growing pains there? Is that part of what went on Saturday?
I think if you look at 158 yards rushing, one play is 56. You look at whatever the passing number was, 156 yards passing. I don't think there was a big, we didn't know what was going on. I think they executed some plays well. Obviously, when you give up a 56-yard run, that sort of kills it. But I'll tell you, the guys sort of responded to that being down. I think at that point, 14-0, came right back on the field, got a 3-and-out. You saw some sacks, you saw some takeaways. So I don't know if there was a communication issue or anything. We didn't execute on one play that led to a 56-yard game, which is 25% of their yards per day probably. But I thought our guys did compete. I thought they showed great effort. I thought when they got down, they didn't change the way they operated. There was no quit, and there was a lot of fight. So I think first game, everybody's on everybody from a defensive standpoint. But I didn't feel like the game just got out of hand on us defensively. We couldn't stop them. I mean, there's a bunch of second longs. I think they were 4-for-12 on third down. So that was some good things were done. We just didn't execute consistently throughout that game, which led to the plays.
Yeah, what happened with the 56-yard run? Was that something you adjusted after that, or was that just an individual thing?
No, I think it was a collective execution of the play itself called. We didn't get lined up properly in time before the ball was snapped. And I think that sort of caught us off guard. And when you don't have an edge to your defense, you have no chance. So we didn't have an edge to our defense based on the play call. We didn't execute the play correctly, which falls on me. We didn't get aligned correctly initially. So I think that was a combination of communication, execution, and again, no edge, no chance. And once he got on the edge, what the play was called, we didn't have an edge to our defense.
Time to catch.
Coach, it seemed like the corners did a really nice job of keeping their receivers out of the game. They didn't have a whole lot of catches, a whole lot of yards. The overall play of those guys, what you thought of that?
I thought they did well. I think they I probably could have put them in some more situations to play tighter man coverage at times or not, based on the way the game was going. But I thought they did well. If you look at the catch chart, you know, the tight end had most of the receptions, the receivers on the outside, one or two catches, not really explosive plays, which you need explosive plays. So I thought on the outside they did a good job. I thought also they did a good job of blitzing. You see Reese got the sack. A couple of disruptive plays on the perimeter where we were able to get a TFL, tackle for loss. So I thought they did some good things. Wished there was a couple of plays there. We wish we could have had a chance when the tight ends make a couple of plays and go and get 10 for the ball. But I thought they had a solid game all game.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about the havoc stats. I know you're that's a huge emphasis. You feel like you guys created enough on Saturday, if not that game?
Our metric for havoc is 20% per game. And in that game, well, first of all, when you lose a football game, there's never enough of anything. There's not enough execution. There's not enough, you know, I didn't coach well enough. All those things. spirit and character and the fight within our players. But from a havoc standpoint, our standard per game is 20%, and in this game it was 19.5. So we were short, and we left opportunities on the field. We missed some TFLs. We had some tip balls that could have been INTs. We had some sacks, and if one thing goes right here or there, we're a step away from a sack. So I think we had a chance to hit our goal. We missed it, and so we didn't get enough. And also, we didn't get enough takeaways or sacks in the game to give us a chance to win in the end, because that's on us. We control how much havoc we create. Nothing else, no one else does. So we control that. So we have to be better than that.
Yes. Yes, obviously. Linebacker lineups, I mean, against obviously a power offensive team here. So is that something you guys like to do a lot on, and how did you feel with James did stepping in there as a third linebacker?
We are a matchup defense, so as it goes, they get big, we get big, they get fast, we get fast. So I think in those situations, you like those bodies. In the end, we want to put the best 11 on the field for the situation. Being a first game, not quite knowing what you're going to get, guys coming back from injury, like a Lino coming back from injury from a year. You want to make sure you have a game plan that can be utilized throughout a game. It's not based on one player. So I think as the year rocks along and teams and certain things, you'll see us be a matchup unit. But we're going to find creative ways and good ways to get our best 11 players on the field.
Tyler Lesman.
Coach, I hope you're doing well.
I'm doing great.
You talked about just limiting the big plays. I guess as you continue to try to build off of the defensive performance last week, what are the biggest things that you're looking for to continue to improve?
Explosive play-wise, I think we have three or four explosive plays that we criticized out that we've passed over 20 or over 10. I think we had three or four of those. Obviously, the one run I would call catastrophic, where you give up a home run ball for 7-1, that's a catastrophic run, which we can't have any of those. We're limited explosives. We can't have any catastrophes to be a great defense. So I think it goes back to what I said earlier about we have to have edges to our defense. We have to execute, and you have to have 11 guys talking as one on the field. So when you do that, and you do the things we always want our DNA, we fly to the ball, we create takeaways, you're going to have a pretty good chance to stop catastrophics and pretty much limit explosives. And on the catastrophic play, we didn't. And on the other three explosives we gave up, there was a breakdown somewhat, and there was a couple times that, you know, a guy made a play, which happens in football. But I think for us, it gets back to communication, execution, building edges, and making sure that we keep the ball in between our defensive units.
Thanks, Joe.
Appreciate you guys.